question I get asked all the time is how I go about setting up all my stuff to make sure everything's to hand. I actually think that's really important when I'm fishing. If I've got everything to hand and everything's organised and safe, it means I can concentrate on the most important thing, which is the fishing itself. So I'm going to run you through how I set my box and the accessories up to get the perfect setup so I know when I'm fishing, I can concentrate on catching that next fish. The mistake I see a lot of people make is they set the box up high to start with. Now, I know from experience that when you're sitting as low to the water as possible, that's when you're at your most comfortable. When you go to Ireland and places like that, we can get to water level. It really is really comfortable. So when you're on a commercial and the platform is a little bit higher, the last thing you want is to set your box up high to start with. So what I always do is I put my box down with all the feet at the minimum level they can go. And then what I do is I adjust the box from that minimum level to make sure that the box is level. So I might have to pick each foot up just a little bit on each one or something like that, but there'll always be at least one leg that is at the minimum level. Start from that point. That makes you a lot more comfortable and it means you're a lot lower to the water so you can keep nice and focused. To me, it's really important that I have everything to hand while I'm fishing, and that starts with my side tray. Now, I know some people like a smaller side tray or maybe two small side trays. Personally, I think as long as you've got enough space on your side tray for what you need, then that's fine. I always opt for this monster side tray. Now, this gives me all the space I need to put everything that I'm going to use for fishing. Sometimes I actually use a similar side tray on the other side when I'm at really big events. But when I'm fishing on commercials and I only need a few things to hand, one's more than enough. But what it does do, it allows me to keep everything here. So I've got my bait here at the front. I've got a few micro pellets here for looking for the method feeder. I've got my hook length boxes, bit of lube, my towel. Everything's here, right here, so I don't have to do anything. I'm sat on the box. The bait's right to hand. I've got it at a nice high level. I see a lot of people setting their side tray up too low and they're reaching down trying to get to everything. When you're here on your box holding the pole, you need to have everything right here, not reaching for it. That helps you concentrate on the fishing. So a big, decent side tray with everything to hand is an absolute must. So speaking about having everything to hand, you can see here, I've got the landing net well secured on a pole hook. I think that's really important. See a lot of anglers, they have it trapped down here in the box area. Trouble is you can pick it up, it can get locked on things and it's not very easy to use and the net can get in your way in front of you. If you're here, you've got it in this pole support, it doesn't matter how windy it is or what happens, it's always there, it's out of the way. Once I've netted a fish and put it in the keep net, I can just put it there out of my way. I don't have to worry about it. I've used that for a long time now and it's become really, really part of my fishing and really, really successful. The other thing I've done is I've got this deluxe kit safe here, which has got all my top kits and my rod secure to one side. Again, I see anglers with top kits right behind them. That means your landing net's just going to clatter them once you net a fish. When I've got them here, off to my left-hand side, which is my preference, it means that while I'm fishing, I don't have to worry about anything knocking them over or getting them away. If I can't get them into the left, I'll stick them to the right. Obviously, again, to one side, try and avoid putting them behind you if you can. When you've got things secure and in a safe place, it means you can focus on the most important thing, which is the fishing. Don't forget that. Keep net position is also important. As you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 keep nets can be required on a lot of fisheries these days. Set up 2 today. Having them straight in front of you is really important to me because when I unhook a fish, I don't want to be reaching or trying to put a fish in a keep net a long way away. They're straight here, I can put the fish bang in front of me and I know that I don't have to worry. You can also see they were quick and easy to set up because I've got them on the accessory bar with a snap lock in place, which means I can just literally put the keep net in and it's ready to go at the start of the day. If I need a third keep net, I just bang it in one of the other fittings. It's dead, dead easy. Having your keep nets in the right place is an essential part of your setup. Having your pole safe and secure is one thing that's really important when you're pole fishing. Obviously, it's an expensive piece of equipment and you want to look after it and you want to have the confidence that when you're handling the fish and getting them in under control, that you know the pole is secure. I use 2 pole rollers when I'm fishing over about 10 or 11 meters. And one of the mistakes I see people make is you set the first one up directly behind them. If you're trying to ship your pole back like this directly behind you, it's very awkward to do, especially if it's low and straight behind you. The secret is having the pole roller nice and high and out to one side. So then when I ship back, I can strike into my fish and just push that pole straight back behind me, straight onto those two rollers. Nice and secure, it's not gonna go anywhere. That is absolutely essential. And you can see the same when I'm shipping out, it's just a couple of pushes, nice and smooth, across my body, and I'm ready to go again. Safe and secure at all time, and perfect control of my fish when I get them near the net. So finishing off, just want to talk a little bit about the pole support and the rod support. You can imagine here, when I'm fishing a pole, it's really important for me to have this pole in a double sock. I really do like the pole socks, and you can see I've got it on the front leg. When I'm fishing, I just pick out the pole, put the top kit on, and I can ship out and away I go. You can imagine if that pole sock was further back, I'd be reaching for it, I'd be trying to fiddle around back here, and it's not as comfortable. So having it on the front leg, for me, is the best place to have your pole sock. The double pole sock's really important because it means I can break the pole down and put spare sections in there, maybe half the pole at one time, or even use the ripple bar for a big section of pole to keep it secure in the meantime. When I'm not fishing with a pole, I'm probably fishing a feeder or a rod. And you can see here, I've got the butt rest, which comes up here and supports the rod at the back with a rod rest at the front. The rod's locked in place for that positive bite and I can pick up and everything's nicely to hand. This completes the setup on this side. You can see the main theme throughout has been everything is to hand and everything is comfortable and secure. Keep that in mind when you're setting up your station, and you're definitely going to catch more fish.